Hello there, YouTube. This is Necrostevo, and it's time for our Week 3 Team Builder in the Alpha Pokemon League. Now, this battle will be up against August, the coach of the Carolina Persians, and if you don't want to watch the whole Team Builder, there will be a link in the description to jump right to the battle. But be sure to check out August either way, because he is a very inventive battler, and I've enjoyed bouts against him a few times, so definitely check out his channel. And if you have time, he also is the one who made the layout that we are using, or that I'm using around it. So, very talented individual for sure. Now this matchup is a bit of an interesting one. We see that he has drafted Ferrothorn, Rotom Wash, Snorlax, Alolan Dugtrio, Malamar, Thunderous Therian Form, which is a Z user, Mega Charizard X, Gallade, Luminion, Drifblim, and Ambipom. So, very solid. We literally see there each core that people tend to try to grab in league format, so our work is really cut out for us in a difficult fashion here. But that being said, let's take a look at the team that we are bringing this week. You can see that I have Garchomp here, just max speed, max attack, Jolly Nature, with Stealth Rock, Earthquake, Stone Edge, and Fire Blast with the Rough Skin, and a Yachiberry. Yachiberry is just in case Thunderous T tries to bring Hidden Power Ice. I can live a hit and kill it with a Stone Edge, barring a Chariberry. And Stealth Rocks are just great against his team. Any team that has Charizard on it, you're going to want to bring that for extra pressure. But he just doesn't have that many good ways of getting rid of hazards. He has Defog on Luminion, and of course he can taunt with a couple of Pokemon, or Fake Out, for example, with Ambipom to stop hazards from going up. But with Ruskin, we can really punish some of those options too. Fire Blast is on there just for Ferrothorn. Even though I have a Jolly Nature because I didn't want to lower my special defense, Fire Blast does a solid amount of damage, and if Ferrothorn switches into an Earthquake, a Fire Blast followed up will knock it out, barring an Aqua Berry to weaken the Fire Blast. But my main win condition this week is going to be my Mega Tyranitar. We'll be packing Dragon Dance, Stone Edge, Crunch, and Substitute with an Adamant Nature for maximum power. Now, with an Adamant Nature at plus one, Mega Tyranitar does outspeed Ambipom. Ambipom is his fastest Pokemon. You could have some Scarfers in there, but that's what we have teammates for. Also, really, Scarfers on his team would help me out a lot because it would lock down his options a fair bit. But if you look at his team and you look at Stone Edge and Crunch, he doesn't really have a lot of switch-ins to both of those moves, and that's why Tyranitar is just going to be clicking Substitute on something like the Ferrothorn, maybe the Rotom Wash or the Snorlax, trying to set up. I can also click Substitute on, if he brings a Scarfed Thunderous, I can click it on that. I can click it on the Luminion. I can't click it on Drifblim or Ambipom, just because of the weird natures of the sets that he might be bringing with him. It's a little bit testy to do that. But there are enough Pokemon there that I can click Substitute on, and then set up a Dragon Dance. After one Dragon Dance, I can 2 AKO his entire team. And that is nothing to, I guess, sneeze at. I was trying to think of something besides sneezing. But, you know, just, I guess, cough at. You could cough it. I don't know. Anyways, up next we have Kolmios the Arcanine, once again my Z user. This time we have the Phytinium Z with the close combat, because he only has Drifblim for fighting type moves. I guess Gallade too, but Gallade really won't like taking that. I'm expecting him to bring Rotom Wash in on like a Flare Blitz or an Extreme Speed maybe, because I could see him bringing a defensive Rotom Wash. Or on the other hand, if he brings a Curslax and it gets set up, like one or two curses, I can still blow it back pretty hard with a Phytinium Z close combat or an all-out pummeling. Also, with Intimidate, that allows me to soft check things like the Snorlax or the Charizard X or the Gallade, not the Malamar. If I bring it in and Intimidate the Malamar will get a plus one. Don't want to do that. That's a no-no. So I'll have to remember to be on the lookout for that. But Toxic is there in case I need to catch something on the switch-in. I could very easily see Mega Charizard switching in to Arcanine. Charizard doesn't like to take Z or the All-Out Pummeling, but I don't really want to waste it on Charizard either. It's a lot easier to Toxic it and then swap out to another one of my Pokemon, so we'll kind of be playing with that just a little bit. Up next, we have Dodrio once again this week. Dodrio is rocking a choice band with Brave Bird, Double Edge, Quick Attack, and Jump Kick, just because that mercs his entire team. Even Rotom Wash is to get KO'd by a banded Double Edge, and that's even without rocks. So he doesn't really have a switch into this, and his team isn't really that fast outside of the Ambipom, so I figure that this made a lot of sense. Quick Attack is just there in case I need to pick off a Scarf Thunder Res or something like that. After that, we have our Rapid Spinner. We really need a Rapid Spinner when our opponent has a Ferrothorn, and this is a Rapid Spinner that can potentially beat Ferrothorn. So, I don't know why I keep saying Ferrothorn. Ferrothorn. Pharaoh is an Iron Base. Anyways, Rapid Spin, High Jump Kick, Drop Kick, and Aromatherapy. Finally, not a Max set. This set has enough speed for a Rotom that doesn't invest in speed at all. Like, he can put maybe 40, maybe 60 points in there, and then I'll still outspeed him. And that's just in case I get burned. I want to be able to hit him with a Drop Kick, and then if I get burned, then I can heal him with Aromatherapy and then kill him with another Drop Kick is the main reason there. This investment going Adamant also allows me to 2-hit KO Ferrothorn with the High Jump Kick, and possibly 2-hit KO Snorlax as well. So yeah, otherwise I was going to go with the more defensive Serena, but why waste that wonderful base 120 attack? And then the last slot, we are finally bringing Forgis to its first debut this season. We have max HP, almost max defense. I have a lot of speed there, once again, just for the Rotom. No sense in letting Rotom get the jump on me with Pain Splits and the like, so that's why that's there. I do have Hidden Power Fire, just so I'm not completely walled by the Ferrothorn, but I will really be using Moonblast most of the time. His only switch into Moonblast is really the Snorlax or the Alolan Dugtrio, and I can kind of set up on the Snorlax, and Dugtrio, I can bring in my Serena pretty easily on it. So I have some options there for sure. So that's the team. I'm definitely expecting him to bring the Ferrothorn, the Rotom Wash, the Thundurus, the Charizard, and the Ambipom. Outside of that, he could really bring any of the remaining Pokemon. Because I don't have a dedicated fighting type, I definitely see Snorlax coming. And Malamar could be interesting as well, depending on the set that he brings with it. But I think I have enough options to hit it hard enough that I won't be able to get set up. Really, the biggest threats are the Thundurus and the Charizard, because they have the ability to boost their speed. So that's why I went ahead and brought two priority options this week as well. So Drifblim has the ability to boost his speed too with Unburden. So things to look out for. And thank you guys for watching the team board. So we're going to get right into the battle now. Please enjoy.
Alright guys, so thank you so much for watching the team builder. If you did not, of course, a quick rundown on my team is going to be Mega Tyranitar, Yachi, Chomp, with Stealth Rocks. We have our choice banded Dodrio, defensive, Florges with Calm Mind and Hidden Power Fire, pretty offensive Serena with Rapid Spin, Aromatherapy, and Drop Kick and High Jump Kick, and all-out pummeling Arcanine with access to extreme speed as well. So just a few techs there. We can see that our opponent actually did not bring all of what we expected. We got the Ferrothorn, the Charizard, and the Rotom, and the Thundurus, but Gallade and Dugtrio were on kind of the short list of things that I expected to be brought against me. So it'll be interesting to see what those are. He has several potential leads in this matchup, but Garchomp beats all of them bar Rotom. Garchomp, I guess, might struggle against his own Charizard, but I'd be faster than him anyway. So, we're just going to lead off with Garchomp and hopefully set up our rocks, or if it's the Thundurus, we will take that opportunity to Stone Edge it in the face. So he actually does end up leading off with his Thundurus, which is fine. I will definitely throw this Stone Edge off here. He swaps out immediately into Rotom, which makes me wonder if he scarfed or something like that. Otherwise, he would have just gone for his move. Rotom misses a Will-O-Wisp, which sucks at the time. It doesn't end up mattering too much, fortunately. And I get up my Stealth Rocks for free. And I do go out to Florges in case he Will-O-Wisps again. Then I can just... Florges doesn't really care if it's burned and it's better than being toxic. He misses a Hydro Pump, but that also didn't matter too much just because he's a defensive Rotom. And with Florges' bulk, it would not have done very much anyways. He does get the Volt Switch out into his Dugtrio after I hit him with the Moon Blast. And Florges can take an Iron Head from Dugtrio unless it's banded. But there's no point in taking that extra hit. Dugtrio has pathetic HP as far as its stats go, so I just go out to Serena to take the hit. And I went for a Trop Kick knowing that if he swapped out into Rotom, it would do a lot of damage or kill it. Everything else doesn't really like the attack drop. Here I did stay in and go for High Jump Kick on Charizard, even though he could have Flare Blitzed me, because I wanted to keep offensive pressure on him. And if he went for a Dragon Claw or something, it wouldn't have KO'd my Serena anyways. Now, thinking that he would go ahead and go for the Flare Blitz now, I switch out to Garchomp, but unfortunately he does Roost again. And I figured, okay, if he Roosted again, he's probably going to go for a Dragon Claw. And so I double back out to Florges, which works out pretty well. He does start setting up. Thanks to the Trop Kick from Serena, he's only at plus one speed, and he's at backhand neutral attack. And so he really needs plus one attack to KO me with the Flare Blitz. And so I want to put him in a range to where he's forced to Roost and take more damage. Or if he takes out my Florges on the double down, he's going to go down too. And of course, that is the best type of down. Wonderful, delicious double downs. Gotta love them. Now on the double down, I do go out to Arcanine because I can threaten everything that he has, basically. He goes out to Ferrothorn trying to get up some hazards, most likely. And I just went for a Z close combat because everything would take good damage from that. Rotom goes down. Probably the best sacrifice that he had right there. I didn't think I could live an Earthquake from Dugtrio, and I was really tempted to go out to Dodrio, but I decided to play on the safe side and go to Serena, which worked out really well because he actually went for Stone Edge, predicting my Dodrio. And to pay me back for those misses early, unfortunately he flinches my Serena. Definitely would have KO'd him with High Jump Kick had I been able to connect with that. Even Trop Kick had a chance to KO Dugtrio just because of its low HP stat. He pulls the tricky Memento out here, which of course lowers my attack and special attack, and that gives him an opportunity to go out into Ferrothorn here. And that's unfortunate because now my Fire Blast isn't doing hardly any damage to him. He's recovering most of that with his Leech Seed. I was very tempted to just go for another one, but I was afraid he would stay in and protect. And so I went out to Arcanine, and he predicts that and goes for another Leech Seed, which means he's getting more HP back. Fortunately, I can go for Flare Blitz here as a no-drawback play, and he brings in Gallade, maybe hoping that I went for another move, but that's fine by me, because now I just get to finish Gallade off with an extreme speed. That leaves him now with just his Thundurus and his Ferrothorn, and I went for the extreme speed there just to make sure that he was in range for a Dodrio banded quick attack. And after the Leech Seed, he's no longer in range, but he actually overpredicts and goes for Hidden Power Ice. And he just stays in and uses it again. So now that's basically confirmation that he's choiced in some way. But because of that, and because of the Stealth Rock, he's only at 4% HP. So if he swaps out and comes back in, he'll die to the Stealth Rock. And if he stays in and goes for Hidden Power, it won't do anything to Tyranitar, and then he'll die to the Sandstorm. And so I get to have a free substitute up, and that's going to be Curtains for his Pokemon, because neither of them can take a hit from my Mega Tyranitar. So that's going to be that battle, and that means that we win 3-0 against August. Fantastic battle, thank you very much, sir. I did enjoy it. And it was really excellent, actually, to see the team play out kind of the way I wanted it to. Dodrio didn't get a chance to hit the field, but my opponent also didn't bring what I thought he would bring. I definitely thought Snorlax was coming because of my lack of fighting types and that type of thing. But yeah, August is definitely no slouch, so be sure to check out his channel and Twitter if you need him to make any cool graphics or anything like that. And this means that we are now 3-0 for the season so far, so we'll be rolling forward into week 4 with an undefeated record. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you all soon. Have a great day.